warrants of arrest are served for fugitive Philippine televangelist Apollo Quiboloy and his co-accused at their religious compound in Davao City. Agents of the National Bureau of Investigation met no resistance and were allowed to hand the warrant to Quiboloy's lawyers. Quiboloy has been in hiding since warrants for his arrest were issued in April. The pastor and several officials of his Kingdom of Jesus Christ group are charged with child and sexual abuse and qualified human trafficking. The Philippine Labor Department vows to provide livelihood assistance to workers who will be affected by the shutdown of offshore gaming hubs. Willard Cheng reports.
The Department of Labor and Employment assured local workers in the Pogo industry that will be displaced following the president's shutdown order of livelihood assistance and the necessary intervention. Labor Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma said his department continues to profile the affected workers to help facilitate job matching and provide the proper livelihood assistance. This also includes training or retraining for other jobs. The DOLE targets to complete the profiling not later than next month by asking Pogo companies for the profile of their employees. Laguesma said the department will also look into what special programs can be provided to family members of the affected employees. The department is closely coordinating as well with PAGCOR to look at other employment-related assistance that can be given to the employees and help them avail of government unemployment insurance benefits, for instance.
Papasyalan namin, pero nakangiti po kaming papasyal at sabihan sa kanila na nais naming makatulong sa mga manggagawa. Kung kayo po ay, at isa lang po ang nang gusto namin sanang mahiling sa inyo initially, bigyan niyo po kami ng listahan ng mga manggagawa ninyo na pwede pong mapinsala nang sa ganun makapag-intervene kami. So ang target namin dyan ay not later than next month. Dapat hawak na namin lahat ng profile ng mga manggagawa. Nang sa ganun, ma-match na rin namin sila. Yung mga nakalatag na kasi yung aming mga possible intervention. Job facilitation, livelihood, training, retraining, or even probably matching them sa available na jobs. Gagawin po ng DOLE yon sa tulong ng ibang mga departamento.
Ask if the DOLE will also assist foreign workers who have legitimate alien employment permits. Laguesma said that DOLE will also look into what kind of assistance can be given them as well. Through its regional offices, the Labor Department has also started to assist sectors that have been affected by the oil spill in the Manila Bay, particularly those in the National Capital Region, Regions 3 and 4A. Laguesma said funds have been set aside to provide livelihood assistance, such as cash for work, not only for fisherfolk, but also seafood vendors that have been affected.
Tuloy-tuloy pa rin po ang profiling. Hindi lamang po ang mga mangingisda at yung mga magsasaka ang pwede pong matulungan. Dahil alam naman po natin, kasabay ng halos magkasabay po yung pagpasok din ng Typhoon Karina at nung habagat. So nagsisimula rin pong magbigay ng assistance ang ating mga regional offices. Hindi lamang po sila ang tinitignan o bibigyan ng pagkakalooban kasi yung pong programa ng DOLE na ang pangalan po ay Tupad para po sa mga displaced at saka disadvantaged workers.
Laguesma said some 1,357 Tupad workers have been helping in the cleanup. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. meets with two visiting U.S. congressmen and thanks them for supporting the U.S.-Philippine alliance. Republican lawmakers Michael McCaul and Addison Graves paid a courtesy call to the president in Malacañang. McCaul assured the president of the Philippines' inclusion in the U.S. government's foreign military financing program. Washington announced last week it would provide $500 million in military funding to boost Manila's external defense capabilities. Filipino troops and their American, Canadian, Australian counterparts successfully conclude their two-day quadrilateral drills. The exercises in the Philippines' exclusive economic zone included submarine warfare drills and cross-deck landing operations. The Philippine Armed Forces Chief General Romeo Browner Jr. noted the importance of the exercises in boosting regional security and promoting deeper cooperation with Manila's allies. Separate joint exercises of Filipino and American troops took place in the Philippine province of Nueva Ecija, where Filipino soldiers had an opportunity to train with America's High Mobility Artillery Rocket Systems, or HIMARS. Agricultural group SINAG warns against the immediate administration of ASF vaccines on affected hogs. The group says the vaccine developed in Vietnam should undergo proper testing first, as it may worsen the spread of the viral disease in the country. Last year, the Bureau of Animal Industry recommended the so-called AVAC vaccine from Vietnam to be commercially distributed in the country following positive results of its trial in Luzon. The Agriculture Department also gave assurance the vaccine is safe and effective.
Yung vaccine kasi, for trial pa lang dito sa ating bansa. So hindi natin pwedeng mabilisan na ilabas itong vaccine sa isang area no, na tinamaan. Ibig sabihin kung may tama yung baboy, kung itong bakuna ituturok natin, baka mag-mutate. Kasi ibang, itong vaccine na ito is live vaccine. So may strain yan na ginawa sa Vietnam. Tapos yung strain natin ito kung iba, tapos ituturok ito, baka mag-mutate yan ng other mutation na mas mahirap natin i-control. Very critical ito. So kailangan may proper handling and testing muna kung ito ba maganda.
Hog racers affected by African swine fever outbreak in Batangas set to get vaccines in the next 2 weeks. The Agriculture Department says it is now preparing to procure at least 10,000 doses of ASF vaccines, all for free. ASF cases were reported in at least 8 towns in Batangas, with the municipalities of Lobo and Calatagan placed under a state of calamity. The DA, meanwhile, gave assurance it is working to provide vaccines to other parts of the country affected by the viral disease. The government has allocated 350 million pesos to procure over 600,000 doses of ASF vaccines.
Sa ngayon, may 251 na barangay sa buong bansa yung may active cases ng ASF. Outside nitong tinatawag natin na emergency purchase, yung ating regular procurement ay ongoing din naman. So within the third quarter, magiging tuloy-tuloy itong tinatawag natin na controlled and monitored vaccination para sa ibang area. Tuloy-tuloy ito, by end of the year, ay hopefully magkakaroon na tayo ng commercial approval. Itong tinatawag natin na ASF vaccine.
The Philippine Senate is considering reducing the number of holidays in the country. Senate President Chiz Escudero says the move aims to improve the competitiveness of Filipino firms and employees.
Mahigit isang buwan na ang holiday sa buong bansa, which makes Philippine companies and workers less competitive. Halimbawa, ang Estados Unidos, meron silang President's Day. Lahat ng magagaling nilang presidente, pinagsama-sama nila sa isang araw na lang na holiday. Tayo, hindi. May araw ng kagitingan, may National Heroes Day. Bawat bayani, nung pinatay sila, may holiday na naman.
As for Labor Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma, having many holidays has both positive and negative effects.
Ang pagkakaroon ng maraming holiday kasi ina-associate ng ating mga employers sa epekto sa productivity at saka karagdagang gastusin. Meron siyang plus minus. Holidays are also necessary in the sense that it provides the workers na nag-i-enjoy noon life with the family. Meron siyang pagre-recharge at medyo maiwasan din yung burnout o boredom sa trabaho niya.
Local lender Metrobank offers Filipinos an early Christmas present with the launch of a program enticing its customers to plan their finances ahead of the holidays. The details from Jackie Pascual.
It's not the holiday season yet, but singer Jose Marichan already serenaded a crowd at a Makati Mall with his iconic Christmas hits.
The start of the Christmas season, I don't know why they chose me to sing. You know, when Christmas time comes around, I become like a child again.
Chan was part of a Metrobank event where bank officials expressed confidence of growth in lending this holiday season. This despite elevated inflation.
People still need a home to live in. People still need to travel. but we have a lot of options.
To entice more Filipinos to get a home or car loan, the bank has unveiled holiday deals like waiving up to 100,000 pesos in fees. They also urge the public to do their New Year's resolution this August instead of January.
We create a new tradition. Let's make our financial resolutions in August before the biggest holiday season so that our financial resolutions can be actionable and realistic.
Officials say Filipinos should plan on how to save or spend their Christmas bonus as early as August so they can start the new year in better financial standing. Metrobank's consumer portfolio posted a 13.7% growth in the first half of the year, and it's optimistic for higher growth this holiday season. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Oil prices headed lower next week in what would be the fifth straight week of fuel price cuts. Estimates show a liter of gasoline could be cheaper by up to 2 pesos and 60 centavos per, while diesel prices could see a cut of up to 2 pesos. As for kerosene, prices could go down by at least 2 pesos and 20 centavos. Imported fuels have been gone down this week due to weak demand, recession fears, and a stronger peso, which benefits importers.